Perhaps I will start. The others will join us soon, I guess. I wanted to start actually before I do my PowerPoint presentation to give some comment on what was told before in the last session, because to understand what I'm going to present is that our structure Dommelhof, everything which you are going to see is possible only with public money. In Flanders, to work in arts in a structural base is actually not possible by private funding. It's important to think to understand the difference. That is already a long time ago that our governments, I must speak in plural, had a decision to make art accessible for a lot of people, art and education. And that's also the starting point of my presentation. It's the reason why Dommelhof was built in the late 60s. It was to have a network of cultural centers which made it possible for the normal audience who are not used to go to the theater, to the ballet, or to the national orchestra, that they also could enjoy art. In this case, for us, it was performing art. Of course, there were the big structures as the National Ballet and National Orchestra and Opera and so on, but in the countryside or in the smaller villages and towns, there was barely anything. So then the governments decide we start to have a network of cultural centers. It's an official term. So I'm going to tell a bit about Dommelhof. Dommel is a small river that runs over our site. Where do we push here? No. Oh, just that. So Dommelhof is a provincial institute. Provincial, I think, in Austria they use the term region. So Limburg is our province. It's like Asturias is here, the region, I guess. And the province of Limburg is about 850,000 people living there. It's good to know that there are no big cities in that region. And that's also why our province has a long tradition of provincial cultural policy. You see where the province is situated in our small country. You see also 850,000, that's not even the inhabitants of a big city. Then Neerpelt is in the north of our province, and combined with two communities, we have about 16,000 inhabitants. We are 40 kilometers away from Hasselt, which is our capital of the province. And it's the same distance to the capital of Brabant's main capital, provincial capital, Eindhoven. And Maastricht is the capital of the province with the same name, Limburg, but then in the Netherlands. We're about 100 kilometers away from Antwerp, Brussels, and Liège, and about 160 kilometers away from Ghent, Amsterdam, and Cologne. So it situates a little bit our position in Europe. We call that the Euregion. And the 16,000, I want to make a quick comparison by the area here, which is going to be built for 12,000 people. That's about the amount of the people who actually live in our village, Neerpelt, because the 16,000 is combined by another community with us. Then the history. Oops, I have to stay here. So there was in early 60s a decision to build Dommelhof. It opened in 67, 68 as the first cultural center in Flanders. Actually, it was built as a theater school, But during construction, those policy games of have arts more democratic and accessible for everybody, they decided to make not a school, but to make it as a cultural center. But as it was intended to be a school, we will see afterwards our infrastructure, it's quite easy to understand why the site is the size it is now. So it, that times it was called Provincial Centrum voor Sociaal Cultureel Vormingswerk, translated as the Provincial Center for Social and Educational, for Cultural and Educational Work. On the bottom line, you see all the names we had during the years. There you see also that is a kind of political influence on that part. In 78, we had the first festival for puppetry. It was also an international well-recognized festival. In 85, it became the Provincial Center for Culture and Sports. So the name changed significantly because in the meanwhile, we had also built a sports center. In 88, we had the first edition of our festival called Theater op de Markt. You have to look here, it's easier. In 95, we became the Provincial Center for Theater and the Provincial Sports Center, so we had two titles. Because at that time we also started the first creation center for theater only, to work to co-produce 2-3 theater pieces a year. And that was the first time that we were involved with co-production creation. Then we had also our festival moving around in the province because it was a bit strange that we had at that time already quite a big edition of Theater op de Markt in our little village with public money from the province. So they decided that we move around the province with our festival. We did that for a few editions. But in 2000, we made an agreement between the festival and our capital Hasselt that we do the festival there for the next editions. Then also again changed our name in Provincial Domein Dommelhof. And in 2007, we started a new work in Dommelhof, which was called TACT, which will be explained later. So the milestones actually were the opening in 67 as the first cultural center of Flanders. In 94, we changed toward a creation center for theater only at that moment. In 2001, we got the first subvention from Flanders community for the festival. In between 2003 and 2005, we got a special subvention for production and development of street art and new circus. The special subvention was especially for our province meant, as they considered us as a little bit poor compared to the other provinces. And just recently we got a new approval of the dossier of, again, significant subvention for the festival. Here have you an aerial view of our site. It's about 10 hectares. 18,000 square meter of buildings with a theater, a residence space, offices, of course, an hotel, a restaurant, atelier, a workshop, outdoor circus spaces, a sports center, a sports possibilities outdoor, and then our park, which is actually a sound forest. Yes. Hotel is perhaps a big name for what it is, but there can sleep about 135 people. The rooms are basic, but clean and modern, but it's not a luxury hotel. Not so bad, no. So here you see an insight of our theater. That's a small theater, 365 places, a stage of 12 by 10. You see the outside a little bit. Our hotel and restaurant, it's architecture of late 60s, as you can see. The right picture is the hotel, let's say, which will be renovated this year to make it more isolated and adapted to the norms we have now for our ecological footprint. A sports center, which is quite big, with also an athletics arena, an official Olympic thing, and the sound forest. It's a park with a permanent exhibition of music, sound installations, I must say, which is quite successful and has a lot of interested visitors. The sound forest is a cooperative project with another organization on our site. It's called Musica. So creation and co-production in Dommelhof is linked on to three actions: to the festival, which is a festival of circus, open air and site specific theater, and to TACT, which is a spin-off of the festival production know-how, let's say, to work also indoor on theater, dance, installation work, and so on. There are also cooperation projects, but of which I'm not going to tell anything else today. So we do make creations in Dommelhof. We facilitate productions and we present those productions. And it's a place for new circuits, theater, street arts, art in public space, and site-specific theater. So the new recognition within the Flemish circus degree I just mentioned, with a significant subvention of €380,000 a year for 5 years, both for presentation and co-production. By this, we become the biggest festival for circus and street and site-specific theater in Belgium. And since 2015, since just recently, the only one with a structural financing of 5 years. The festival is organized in a formula. In the even years, it's a festival, it's a city festival, so it's art in public space. And in the odd years, it's the circus, which we do in Dommelhof. So in the even years, we are in summer, in the beginning of August, in the even years in Hasselt, and we see some pictures. You already see that it's a festival for a large audience. The festival is goes over 4 days, and it's, yeah, you see some pictures. You see that there's also a theater in the festival. There is also acrobatics and circus. And the picture below, you can imagine what that is. They all look up. So in the odd years, we are in Dommelhof at our own site. Dommelhof becomes a kind of circus village. And on the sports fields, we put the tents. And then we have several places to present circus work. It's, as I said, a festival meant for that it should be accessible for a large audience. In Hasselt, we reach about 120,000 visitors on those 4 days. And our audience is really mixed. Adults, children, experts. With experts, I mean people who are used to go to theater or to have kind of experience with art forms, and also the occasional visitor and the passenger by. On those 4 days, we show 40 to 50 different productions. Those productions, 40, 50, which is rather a lot, is the result of European-wide scouting for good shows and make a severe selection of what is what you can buy on the market, let's say, and what is possible for us to present in Hasselt. And of course, we show also the creations made in Dommelhof, which were co-productions or co-financed by the festival. Because we do a lot of co-production, co-financing, we call ourselves a creation festival. That's an evolution in our history a little bit, because before we did no creation, we just bought the shows, showed them to the audience, but now it's changed a lot towards be involved with the production, with the artists, to make things together and then show it to our audience. So why we think it's a festival in a real context, not on the part of, not only on the part of showing it, but also on the part of co-producing it, as well in public space as in the nature, as in a rural environment or park. The selection is internationally and Flemish. Flemish is quite important to mention, because when we started with the festival, the main things you would see there are French and Spanish big companies with impressive shows, and there were barely Flemish artists that performed in the street. There were some, but thanks to initiatives as we have in Dommelhof, that we could support them, the more and more artists came out of their comfort zone and went to the street to try to do things in public space. So actually, it made a quite significant difference for several Flemish artists that there was a production center in Flanders for street arts, for art in public space. This explains a little bit the criteria why, on what we are showing in the festival. So it should be artistic challenging. There will be premieres, special projects, inter or cross-disciplinary. Actually, it's a mix of all kind of presentations, because we are looking, we're targeting on a very large audience. There should be presentations that are easy accessible, easy to understand, and so on. But I will see also more arty things, perhaps very contemporary dance, installation work, and so on. It's a mix of aesthetics, of communication with the audience, but it's always, we always try to have it on a very high artistic level. But I said it, there are three actions, but I talk about two. We had the festival, and the next thing I want to talk about is TACT. TACT is then producing, supporting artists on the indoor performing arts. So actually, it's the same policy. We try to make creations, to co-produce, and to present the artists we support in our center. And it's the initial idea to start with TACT was actually to support our regional talent, very young artists, to give them support, which they would find much more difficult elsewhere, to have their first own work, to have a place to improvise, to try things, and so on and so on. But of course, we operate in a larger network, let's call it Flanders, and we have to consider them as well to be able to have a kind of synergy between the different organizations in Flanders. So that's why we didn't stick only to our regional artists, but looked further away because of working together in a network of several similar organizations is very important for the artists you support. So focus on development of talent. And yeah, of course, we have a lot of applications, but there's a kind of selection by about 20 criteria. But it's always the main reason is the artistic potential. We give them residencies, other support, the first contact with audience. We organize tryouts for them. We make sure that they got some feedback on what they are doing and so on. TAC is also, for the province of Limburg, the only place where such a thing happens. Of course, in other provinces in Flanders, there are several similar organizations, workspaces where you can do the same thing as you can in Dommelhof, art center that will support young artists, or not so young artists, but good projects. But in Limburg, we are the only one. In Flanders, we are the only one that supports art in public space and new circles. Of course, we collaborate with other players in the field, for instance, with other creation centers, as there's always an example behind, WP Zimmer, with companies, the Quasis, the theater company, with alternative management agencies, as Action Scenic, for instance, or alternative theater houses, as Campo in Ghent, with individual artists, with cultural centers, other cultural centers in our province, for instance, Seamine in Genk, and also with the Academy of Theater in Maastricht in Holland. So we combine sometimes the efforts in the field of creation in our creation center, so for circus theater and street arts or art in public space and or TACT initiatives around theater, physical theater and dance. Sometimes it creates spillovers and artists from different fields discovering each other in our center, which is quite nourishing, I think you see. Our audience has the opportunity to find very different artwork, new disciplines, crossovers, and so on. And the professionals then that way get surprised by what we are showing and doing. At least that's what we hope. What are we then actually offering to those artists? We can offer residency, co-production, co-financing, coaching and feedback, logistic support. Doesn't seem so important, but the logistic support can be very substantial. For instance, in our workshop, we can make a scenography for a theater piece or a dance piece or for a circus artist. Technical support with advice on lightning, on sound, on traveling and so on. Publicity by presenting them. And we offer them also the networks in which we are involved. We also offer, and this is for us, perhaps what makes it a little bit specific and more valuable, is that it can work in a certain context. As you could see, Dommelhof is in the north of the province, has nothing to do. We are in a forest. And that makes them that they are in a protected environment. They are not distracted by other things in the city. They stay focused on the work. They actually get up on a decent time in the morning. They are completely free to work. They have an access code and they come in and out whenever they want. And it's they have a lot of time and space to create what they want. So it's we creating actually a great opportunity and collaboration. they have also, if this mainly we co-produce or support towards a final product. The projects we are choosing should survive. That's the main intention. But there's also room for experiment, to develop, to write, to try things. Our actual input is for is 225,000 euro a year for co-producing. The infrastructure, of course, a bed and meals, and, and our team, administration, clean, artistic, logistic, about 35 people are there involved, not only, of course, for the creation center, and a lot of energy. The output is then the results and the impact of our creation center can be defined on different levels: impact on the audience, on the organization, artistic, economic, and social. Our audience impact results of the work we do and the presentations we do in the festival and other forms. And together with other things happening on our site, we reach 300,000 visitors a year, of which there are, for instance, for the festival in Hasselt, 120,000. And for the festival in Neerpelt, the circus, is 15,000. And we have about 6,500 presentations, not only for our own work, I must say. So 35, 40 different projects. Each year about, we collaborate with about 400 artists, if we count them all together. We had 600 production days and 4,500 overnights. The artistic impact is quite significant. I also mentioned already in the beginning of the presentation that in the early days of the festival, there were barely Flemish artists that were willing or daring to work in public space. Now there are a lot more. Also on new circus, we would never had the quality, for instance, for Circus Ronaldo, if it wasn't have been for Dommelhof, because at that time it was a dying family circus. And thanks to a lot of input, not only from us, but they changed toward a more contemporary and modern way of using their skills in a circus style. But also a young talent, you see here the name of Joke Emmers, which is from our village, a very talented actress. Judith Kleisers is a young dancer, which we support and which gives them opportunity during the years. It's a long time process, but we hope they will reach the level in their career that they want to reach. The impact for us all is also having been part of a lot of wonderful creations. So you do that work, but you need some satisfaction out of it also. We often hear the reaction of artists who were in residence and who were supported by us, that there are very few locations where artists get so much room and time to actually to be concentrated on their work and the surrounding and the nice team we have. There is an economic impact as well. The study of the Flemish Theatre Institute, they made a big study because out of the politics there was a lot of comment why does art has to cost so much money, why so much public money goes to art, why art is necessary. So we turned it over the economic way, and the credit relations were made. It was a big study. And every year the Flemish government invests in art, gives a return of an additional euro and a half. From the tourist industry, they calculated that if somebody goes to a festival for a day or to a city to see a performance, if you see it as a day trip, they spend average 38 euro in that city. If we turn that to Hasselt, and we have 120,000 visitors, times 38 euro generates 4.5 million. But we put some question marks behind those figures. But anyway, it's surely an indication that is that there is an important, a significant turnover on an economic viewpoint. And then, of course, our social impact. And there I want to come back to the discussion which just happened before my presentation. Isn't has been for the decision for the politics in the in the mid 60s, let's say, to build a center in our province and to have several cultural centers in our province and Dommelhof in Neerpelt. It took about 40 years, 50 years to have the recognition that in Limburg there are not only peasants and miners. There are also people involved with art and a lot of good things happen there. Actually now a lot of very talented, important artists looking towards Neerpelt to see if they can work there. They used to look at Ghent and Antwerp and Brussels. So the presence of Dommelhof in such a small village made quite a significant turn in the perception of the rest of Flanders that Limburg also had potential, had also artists, and that there were also possibilities. But of course, it's the effort of a team of people who are motivated and engaged to continue that, and of course politics who found it very important to do that and to help that and to support that with money and with also vision. So, and that also relates a little bit to be included or excluded, which was quite a significant remark, but we think that the way we are in our history, why we are there and why we do the work we do now and related to the audience, I think inclusion of the audience is one of our main concerns. So, social impact. These are the three question marks we constantly have in our minds. It's a bit abstract perhaps, but should we disturb or attract by what we are doing? Can we leave structural marks? Yes, we can. How can we leave visible traces? Then I remember your opening picture. This was a very strong visual trace, but you can also see it in another way. Have you seen a very nice performance? Does it stay in your mind? Can you revisualize it after a week? And so on and so on. So it's a matter of quality as well, but also real traces. We hope we change the city and its inhabitants by artistic intervention, by every artistic intervention we invited. Finally, some PR, an invitation to our next circus festival, which happens end of October, beginning November, in Dommelhof, Neerpelt. There's a direct flight from Graz to Düsseldorf, and then it's a 1-hour drive. Okay, thank you.